Every morning in 7th grade language arts and math at Canyon Ridge School, students gather together for their daily huddle. They all sit in one room with the teachers and go over assignments and standards for the day and week, as well as plan out their individual day. Students have advisory meetings scheduled during the day where the teacher can catch up on their progress. They have sessions available to attend based on their interests and mastery of the standards, and they have free time to work on the tasks that are due that week. After the huddle, the students are off and running. Except for their scheduled meetings and sessions throughout the day, students decide what to work on, when to work on it, how to learn it, and who to work on it with. This revolutionary structure is part of the personalized learning movement in the Dysart Unified School District that aims to provide an environment where students become self-directed expert learners who monitor their progress and take control of their learning.
A lot of the standards, they continue to spiral, and you've got some kids that get things quickly and other kids that do need that remediation of continuing to spiral certain standards or skills. So we wanted to make it to where the kids that did get things quickly could take it to the next step of learning. If they know the 7th grade standards, let's move them to the 8th grade standards. Let's let them collaborate with other kids that are working on those skills and really let them design their own learning.
This personalized structure also provides the opportunity to develop crucial work and life skills within the students that will allow them to be successful in their future.
One of the biggest benefits of personalized learning the way that we're doing it is that they actually have to plan their day. So they have to be organized and they have to know time management. If they miss a meeting, we're at the point where they just don't get a grade for it. They don't miss the meetings. They never miss a meeting. Like, they're always there on time. I mean, not all adults are always there on time, so it's pretty impressive that they're doing that. We've set up reminders and stuff, so they know how to organize it now, but just thinking of going into high school and college already with those skills, I just think it's setting them up for success in a way that we've never done before.
It makes us more responsible for ourselves, attending all the meetings, because then you have to go to the second meeting, which may interfere with another meeting, so you have to be responsible for yourself and for your actions.
Within this structure, the teachers develop personalized learning plans with each student to help guide them through the standards that were already taught and provide resources to help students work ahead or catch up based on their needs.
They have all the standards for 7th grade and we test them on them. And if they haven't mastered the standard, we give them different ways to relearn it, and then they relearn and they retest to make sure they've mastered every standard, especially the priority standards for the grade level.
The initial implementation of this new structure was met with enthusiasm first, and then eventual realization by the students.
At first, they were super excited, and they were really excited to have all this time to talk. And then once we started meeting with them, to submit things, they started realizing, okay, I think I need to modify my time. And so we had, where we would have meetings with the kids and reflect and discuss and make plans for the next week. And they've come so far in being able to manage their time and to know what the expectations are and know how to make themselves successful. You've got kids that have now separated themselves from their best buddies at the beginning of the week so that they can make sure they're on track with their tasks and their learning. It's a constant reflection, not just with the teachers, but we are constantly having the kids reflect with us and getting them to make connections between their successes and their choices throughout the week.
For me, it was really easy to get used to because I felt like there was a lot of weight off my shoulders and I felt like I could learn easier too because I got things done quicker.
For the teachers, this type of structure and environment has been instrumental in pushing their teaching forward because of the ability to now focus more on the students and their needs.
I get more time with my kids. They're able to come to me and just say, hey, I have a question on this, and I'm not trying to teach everyone at one time. So there are some kids I'll give them a resource, they'll get it with that, and they're good, they're going. And then there's some that need a little bit more, and so they will you know, just communicate to me that they need a little more, and we just, small group right there, right then, there's so much more time to give them what they need, and you get to know them a lot better, and you get to understand their needs a lot more because we're more readily available to them, so I love it.
If we ever don't understand anything, they're always open for us to like just come up to them and ask them questions, or we put a sticky note on the door. We have a sticky note system where you put the lesson on the door that you want to do, and they would call little groups for that lesson.
The teachers continue to reflect and refine this approach as student needs change and best practices develop. But one thing that has remained constant throughout their implementation is the belief they are now better prepared to educate their students for a 21st century future.
So I think it's definitely changing the face of education. We cannot be still teaching in rows, you know, like 20 years ago, and expect the kids to still be the same kids that we had 20 years ago, because they aren't. They are gearing their own learning. They're taking ownership in their own learning, and it's more important to them.